price of war is paid by more than fighting men alone. To civilians, too, the hospital ship is help and hope in a world that can use more of both.
This is the International House at the hospital. It's called that because we have Vietnamese, Korean, and Chinese patients stationed on this ward. We're fortunate to have interpreters so that we can easily converse with the patients. And patients from all parts of Vietnam are sent here for varying kinds of special surgery. Come over here, Charlie. This little boy is 5 years old. His name is Chong, so naturally we call him Charlie. He's learned enough English to be able to get all the peanuts and ice cream and pop that he can handle. But unfortunately, Charlie has a congenital heart disease. His surgery is scheduled for 2 days from now.
A human heart lies open. The surgical team is at work. They have stopped the heart to work upon it. A heart-lung machine bypasses the heart to send the vital, living blood coursing through the patient's body. Not war in this case, but the human condition itself created the congenital weakness that now demands the best skills, the highest technology, the uttermost teamwork that medicine can bring to bear. But in this case, war itself has hit hard. A man's heart has stopped. Life hovers just short of death. The doctor's hands seek to stimulate the heart to move again. Can medicine and youth win the battle? For this, too, is a battlefield.
Tonight we sing the glory and the coming of the Lord. He is ramping up the vineyards where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the faithful lightning of his terror from the sword. His truth is marching on.
Receive five emergency patients.